The Kuiper Belt is a region outside most of the planets of the solar system. Pluto was the first Kuiper Belt object discovered, and we didn't discover any more for something like 60 years. And then at that point, we started discovering them rather rapidly. There are tens of thousands of these icy bodies out in the outer edge of the solar system, and they're really the fossil relics of the formation of the solar system.
They are ancient. They contain evidence of our origins. Objects closer to the sun have been greatly transformed by solar radiation. Earth is a very different place now than it was in the early stages of the solar system. But way out in the deep, dark reaches of the solar system, we see things that are more or less as they were.
So the question is, what are they made out of? What's happened to them?
To study Kuiper Belt objects, Henry Rowe is building one of the DCT's first instruments, the Near Infrared High Throughput Spectrograph, or NITES for short.
What NITES is doing is taking all the light that comes in from the object and splitting it up into wavelength, into colors. If we were doing it at the visible, what you would see is how much red light are you getting off this object, how much green light, how much blue light, how much orange light, and so on. We're doing this out in the infrared, where it's a longer wavelength than that, but it's exactly the same concept.
Different materials reflect light in different ways. Analyzing that reflected light will give them an idea of the composition of Kuiper Belt objects.
Looking at objects in that way, we can learn the history of what's happened out there, which in turn tells us what's happened to our solar system over the last 4.5 billion years.